a good herdsman. He knew how to take care of his family. He didn't just have a little bit of something, but he had much already. So he was not a man that wasn't wise and knew how, and didn't know how to handle his household. He knew well how to handle his household. But then God said, I gotta bring down the wise, the wisdom of his own thinking, and the wisdom in which he has learned over time, to sometimes trial and error. I gotta get this man to a place where he wraps himself up in the word of the living God, that he begins to be transformed, translated by the word of the living God. I gotta take him from all that which he is familiar with. I gotta take him away from all of the resources that he is comfortable with. Sometimes God has to take us away from our comfort zone. Sometimes God has to show himself strong in us, that you don't need to depend on man for it. I'm about to do something supernatural, that I want to give it to you myself. So the light affliction, that light little frustration that you suffer going through with it, it's all going to be for the glory of the living God. Not one man is going to be able to say, I did it. See, I gave Pastor Ruby the word, but it was her faith to believe God is the God of the supernatural, that he's going to do it. I'm just going to stay here, even though my money looks funny, even though there's trouble in my household, whether anything he can come up in here, kill, steal, and destroy. My hope has to be in the Lord. I don't like this place. I don't like having to depend on anyone to do anything for me, but I got to let this light affliction suffer just a little while, because sooner or later, the glory of the living God is going to be revealed through my life. Somebody need to say, God, let the glory of you be revealed in my life. Let the glory of your presence be seen all over my face. Work this thing out for the good of me, God, who love you, walking according to your purpose. Don't know how you're going to do it, but I know you're going to do it. Don't know when you're going to do it, but I know you're going to do it, because you are God and you do not lie. You don't contradict yourself, but what you say it and you mean it. And so I believe what you said to me, you mean what you said. So here's Abram is walking away from the familiar to the unfamiliar, but he heard a voice. He heard the word that was sounding loud in his ear, the word that was so resounding that he trembled in his inside, because he knew that there's a reverence I need to give to this word. There's a respect I need to give to this word, because not many days hence, the word is going to manifest. So Abram, in his old age, begins to walk by the sound of the living God, going as God told him. Then God says, Abram, I see your faith has brought you to this ground, this land, and I want you to know, look around your Abram. Everything that you see, I'm getting ready to command some things to take place in the atmosphere. You see the sand under your feet? Even your generation, your seed is going to out.